All right, in this next video, we're going to take a look at the geometry arc tools. Once again, we're going to be in the horizontal geometry introduction drawing. The arc tools are going to be under the open roads modeling, geometry, and we're looking at the arc tools here. I'm going to have my feature definition toggle bar pulled out. Again, that is under the standards and feature definition toolbar. And in here you can again set your feature definitions if you'd like. So you can do the drop down here, do a linear design, and we've been kind of using geometry scratch for some of these, so I'll set that at geometry scratch. Again, that was underneath of the linear design, geometry scratch. And then we're going to set that as an active one. Once we set that as active, everything we draw from here or copy or anything like that will take on the geometry scratch feature definition. Alright, so the first tool that we're going to look at underneath geometry horizontal is the arc tools circle. So we're going to draw a circle. It's a fairly easy tool. The dialog box pops up. It's got a radius value. You can key that in if you want. You can also use Civil AccuDraw if you wanted to do that. Enter center point, so we're just going to come out here on the screen under circle area, left click a beginning point, and left click an end point. You can also key in a radius value. So if I want to key in a radius value, I can left click a center spot, and we can come out here and give it 200 in the dialog and hit enter, and then all we have to do is left click. Once you do that, the difference between a regular microstation circle and one of these circles is when you left click on it, it gives you information about it. So you can increase the size of it by clicking on the dot, or you can also click on the radius itself and key in a different radius. So 275, enter that in and it will change it to that. Same thing with this one. We entered 200. It is 200. We can click on that point and resize it. So pretty easy tool there is a circle as a civil element. Arc between points, that's the next one in our list. We'll just go ahead and left click on that tool. Arc between points, the dialog for this one has several different placement methods, so we'll take a look at a couple of these as we go. We'll do a center radius for the first one. That's fine. We can give it a radius value here, and the start directions and the tangent directions, sweep angles, arc length. So all of that information is available for you to key in if you know it. Also at the bottom, it's got the feature definition and the name. So the way this works, we're going to accept that we're going to do a center radius, so we'll left click that option. Then our radius value, it wants us to enter a center point, and we can key in a radius value if we want. So we're going to enter a center point with a left click. And it's going to draw it out similar to what we were doing with the last tool with the circle. It gives, asks us for a radius value. Okay, if we pull that out, let's say that we're going to do 250. So we'll type that in, hit enter. Okay, and then it wants to know the enter arc start angle. Always important to read and look at your heads up display. You can also see it down here at the bottom. Enter arc start point. Okay, and then so our start can be anywhere out here, so we'll left click on that, and you can see right now we're going at a counterclockwise direction for this one. Okay, so our arc length, then we can key in a length or we can left click to place it. For this one, I'll just left click and place it out there. So that's your method. You would have a center point, a start, and an end. Another one that's used quite a bit is this start end pass through. This is a nice tool if you have to be on a particular point that's out there. You have to pass through that point. So once we make that option available, we can accept that. We want to enter the arc start point. Now you can use snap tools if you want, but I'm going to say that the end of this arc, I want to pass through the end of that arc and be right on it. So our start point, I'm just going to start up here, left side, and then we're going to end it over on this side. So we'll left click another location, and then it says what, where do you want to pass through? So I'm going to snap, just get right on the end of that and snap to that location. So now I have a arc that's got to start here and end there, and I pass through this exact location at the end of that arc. So that's a couple of your arc tools. Then we've got some tools that are similar to the line tool that we just went over in the last video. So if we go up to the top, we've got the arc to element, and we're going to take a look at the simple arc to element. This tool, the dialog has a trim and extend of back. It's got a radius you can fill in and the feature definition. So we're going to come down here and it says locate the element. So we're going to left click on the arc and let's give it a radius of 750. So we'll key 750 in and hit enter. And it wants to know the endpoint then at that point. So we can come out here and left click an endpoint. We can also snap to something if we wanted to. So we're going to use the left to do that. So we left clicked out there on the screen. We've got an arc now that is tangent to the other arc. And our trim and extend is set to back. We can hit the down arrow if we want to do none, but I'll left click and accept the back. Okay, so there's the back trim. And now you've got an arc that is to another element. Okay, then we've got arc from an element. Very similar tool. We're going to come down here, arc from an element. Simple arc from element. Same thing, except for now we have an arc length that we can give it, and a radius, and all of that information. So we're going to come out here and left click on that next arc. It says enter a start point. This is where we're going to be tangent to that arc. So we're just going to come out and left click a location. And now it wants to know where do you want to end it. Okay, through point, or you can key in a radius. We're just going to move the mouse out, left click another location. Get our arc length in there, tell it where we want it to end, left click that spot, and then we're going to left click to trim back. Okay, so that's arc from an element. Similar to the one before, except for we're going to tell it where we want to be tangent. Okay, our simple arc tool, come down in here, we've got arc between elements, and we've got the simple arc tool. So here's where that one's located, arc between elements. We're going to come out here, trim and extend. We've got the none, back, ahead, and both because we're going to be between elements. So we'll do both. We can give it a radius if we know. We can also say that this is a loop, so we'll loop around. This is like the fillet tool inside of MicroStation, except for it is civil geometry. So it wants to know the two items that we're going to place this in between. So I'm going to left click on one, left click on the other, and then it wants to know the radius. You can either just left click or you can key a radius in. Let's say that we're going to key in 1,000. So we'll key in 1,000, hit enter. And then all we have to do is left click to accept that. And if we want to trim those back both, we'll make sure our trim option says both, and we'll left click to put that in there. Okay, so now this tool has created a fillet in between the other two lines. And that you can see that would be a tool you probably use quite a bit. So if we're going to take a look at the next one here at arc between arcs, we're going to come up here to the arcs, and we're going to select arc between arcs. A lot of stuff going on in this one. It depends on kind of if you have spiral transitions or not. Okay, if you don't have any spiral transitions, you can set these at none, and the dialog box gets a lot smaller. Or if you set them that you do want spiral, then you give it a length of that spiral. You can also have these other values in here that you can use as your spiral. I'm going to go ahead and set those at none. I don't need a spiral for this particular one. We also have the ability to do a start offset, end offset. If you want to be right on those arcs, which I do in this case, I will turn those offsets on to 0. Okay, our radius, we can fill that in if we know what it is. Trim and extend is right now set at none. I'm going to go ahead and set that at both. And then what kind of curve are you going to have, a compound or a reverse curve? Okay. So we'll keep that at compound for this first time. We're going to come out here on the screen. It says, what kind of curve do you have? So we're going to accept the compound. Then it says, locate the back element. So we're going to make this arc the back element. Then it wants to know your offset, which we have filled in at 0, so we'll accept 0. A head element, we'll pick the other arc, offset of 0, so we'll accept that. And then our through point, as you move to locations where it can solve, it'll actually give you that arc. Okay, if it can't solve it, then that's what that red X is all about. Okay, I want option 2 here, so I'm just going to move my mouse around until I get 2. Option 2. And if it's still not given to you, you can hit the Alt key to get to 2. But we'll left click to place that in there, and then we will trim and extend both with another left click, and that will put that in there. Okay, I'm going to do a quick undo. I have to do 2 of them, at least 2 of them, to get the red line out of there, because when you do a trim back or ahead or both, when you undo, you're undoing the trims first and then you're undoing the element. Okay, so the only thing we're going to do different here is we're going to change this to a reverse curve now. Okay, so we've got it set at reverse curve. We're going to come out on the screen, accept that we're going to do a reverse curve with the left, locate the back element, which is going to be this arc. The offset's going to be 0, so we'll accept that. The ahead element is the other arc. Left click on it. Our offset's going to be 0, so we'll accept that. And then it wants to know how you're going to create this curve. So if you wanted to do 2 again, let's say you want to do 2 again, we'll hit the Alt key until it goes to 2. Move it around a little bit more here. As you can see, whenever you're moving around, you can eventually get to that number 2. And once you get the number 2, you'll accept that and trim and extend both. You kind of get a reverse curve type option happening there. Okay, the last option that we have in here is complex transition between any element and an arc. So the ahead element, it says down here at the bottom, the arc is the ahead element. Okay, so we'll go to arcs. Complex transition between any element and an arc. So the arc has to be ahead. Okay, the way that this one works is we're going to do a start offset of 0 and an end offset of 0. And then we're going to do a trim and extend both. So this is very similar to what we've done before. Okay, we can have spirals or not. And then your name and feature definition. So this one says locate the back element. So according to our note here, we know that the back element's going to be the line. Okay, our offset, we've got that plugged in at 0, so we can accept 0. Our head element is the arc. So we'll left click on the arc. Again, with the offset, we'll accept 0. And then it wants to know where you want to place this particular complex element. So as you move around, you can left click a location that you like, and you can trim and extend both, none, back, or ahead. So you left click to do that. Okay, then after that's done in there, you can modify this line just by getting the element selection tool. Left click on that red line, and you've got a radius that you can change inside of there. You can also modify with the line that's out here. As you can see, the radius is staying the same, but the location that you're placing it is in a different location. All right, and that will conclude the geometry arc section.